Right, folks.
This is another little update on the Land Cruiser project. It's pretty much all done. Everything, I detailed it even further from the last video. Had to work on the air conditioner. I ran some leak detector, and yeah, I found a bunch of leaks on it. So I replaced the front condenser. And then these lines that go all the way to the back for the rear AC, they go underneath the running board there. It's kind of tedious to get to, but they're expensive to replace. It would be these black lines right here. There's actually four of them. The skinny one, which is a high pressure, is one solid line all the way across, and the low pressure one, which is a bigger one, is actually three hoses. There's a middle one, and then the rear and the front. And you have to disassemble those three in order to get them in where they need to go. Well, in order to remove them off the truck, they need to be disassembled, all three of them. And then that skinny one, you just kind of have to wiggle it through. And it comes out. And then the new ones, you do the reverse, and you just feed them all through there, make sure they're all tight, and then you put you test it again, pressurize it, vacuum it, and then make sure you don't have any more leaks. I had to get me one of these little pen lights that are like for the UV little detector. You can shine the blue light on there, and wherever there's dye, you're gonna see green, like fluorescent green. And anyway, so I addressed all the leaks, pressurized it, put some stop leak just to make sure, and some Freon. I think it took like 28 ounces, if I remember right. Anyways, it's working good. And now I'm working on these sway bar bushings. And this is kinda one of the last things I left on this project, because it involves some welding and some fabricating. So I'm gonna be looking at replacing them. Excuse the noise, sorry about the lawnmower. They're cutting the grass up there. But anyway, so the chassis has some rust issues, as you can see. Hope you can hear me. And all this is gonna be reinforced with angle iron. I'm gonna put some angle iron just right here. And then this hole, I'm just gonna, all the holes will be cleaned up, and I'm gonna leave them there as drainage. Just it'll drain any more moisture that might get in there, whatever, including this one. This one's gonna be drained. So I'll clean it up, and I'll put the angle iron here, and then there'll be another piece of angle iron here facing down, so that whatever gets in here will drain out the angle iron. It'll be like a little cup right here, or not a cup, but like a little drain gutter, so all this will just run out the piece of iron. And then up here is where this bracket goes, but as you can tell, I had to remove the old bracket. It was pretty rusted. I know there's a lot of you guys out there that want some information on this and how to fabricate it and all that. You're not gonna find the original OEM bracket unless you go to a salvage yard and cut it out somehow. But you don't really need to. The old one, like here's the one on this side. That's kind of what they look like.
This one looks in good shape. I might be able to just leave that one where it is. Put some new bolts. But the one over here was like really compromised. It was all gone. I'll show it to you here in a minute. In fact, it's over here on the floor. There it is. In front of the ashtray. I'll show it to you. But all this has been repaired. Put some brake lines. A new ABS sensor. These bushings that go here are part of this sway bar assembly. So what I'm going to do is just fabricate the bracket that goes on the chassis. And then weld it. And it's real simple. I'll show you as it goes or whatever, how to fabricate it. Just go to Home Depot and get some angle iron. And that's pretty much it. And then it'll be reinforced, heavy duty, ready to go. Oh, here's those air conditioner lines, the new ones. So all this hardware and stuff came with it. Some of it I had to kind of make my own here. And support it. There's one of the joints on the hoses. But these hoses go all the way back. And I did have to drop the muffler just to get a little more access in there, more to be able to torque the wrenches, which was a good thing. I replaced some of these bolts that were all rusted, cleaned it all up, and I was able to get back in there to touch up the paint and, you know, just remove some more rust that was back in there that I hadn't been able to get to. But it all turned out nice. So now I'm working my way back. The front diff is done. I changed the oil on it. Now I gotta lube, you know, the rest of it. I gotta lube the U-joints here on the drive shafts. It's got synthetic on the diff. Drained it. Put some new CV axles. The boots on the old ones were pretty compromised. Ball joints, lower ball joints, brake lines, yeah. The front end's pretty much done. Now I'm working on this middle section here with this damn bracket. But it'll come out nice, you watch. Once I do this, the driver's side, then I'm gonna go after this side and then probably just replace the bracket on the sway bar. The only bad thing is they come with these little grease nipples that I might not even be able to get to because the torsion bar is like right on it. So I might just get rid of them or leave them on, but they're not gonna be actually used for greasing, I don't think. So let's continue. I'll show you the next phase where I'm at over there trying to fabricate the bracket. Talk to you soon. Bye. All right, folks, here's the other part. It's still tentative, but I want to show you the old sway bar bracket or what's left of it. I had to like split it open, cut one of the bolts off, and then just split it open. But anyway, so the new one, of course, looks like that. And yeah, so I got this piece of angle, some heavy duty, I think it's like 1/4 inch, super thick. And what I was gonna do is cut 4 sections to make 2 brackets. These two, this one would be inverted over here and then butt welded. These two edges would be what butt welded into each other and just flip this piece around. And then, so this would serve as a gusset, and this piece would mount up against the chassis on this side. And then, of course, this hole would be the one for the bracket here. It would go underneath it, of course. Something like this. And then the other half would be on this half over here. And it would be welded to the chassis that goes here. You know, kind of get the idea, right? The only thing is, I don't know if that's kind of the way to go with a weld right here in the middle, which would be like right down the center of this is where the weld's gonna be, which should be okay as long as it's welded properly. And this is the angle iron that I'm gonna be running on the edge of the chassis itself, so it'll actually end up being kind of like this underneath on that edge of the chassis, and then this bracket would end up welding up against this right here. The only thing is, this lip is not tall enough to support the whole gusset. So anyways, I'll show you what I end up doing. I might just end up going with it like this instead and just cut a whole piece of it right here, and then just put a gusset on each corner, on each end, big old gusset, kind of like this. Triangular gusset. I think that would end up being more heavy duty, with maybe a little drain hole in there somewhere so it drains on the corner, and that'd be more heavy duty, man. I think that'll be the way I go, and then that way this angle iron that's on the chassis is gonna be butt welded like that. Mm-hmm. Up against the chassis. Then I'll be able to put a good weld right here on this bracket. We'll see how that goes. All right, folks, talk to you soon. All right, folks, welcome back. Here's my latest invention or fabrication kind of thing that I've done to address this support for this bushing that holds a sway bar up here on this Land Cruiser. So I fabricated a few pieces. This here is just a piece of angle iron. I put a few cuts in it right here, kind of V-notches, so that I could close up this or create like this arch pattern on here to match this arch that's right here. So this angle iron basically is gonna go in here, right up against the frame of the truck, and it's gonna reinforce this whole corner side or corner angle of this frame. There we go. And it just pretty much sits right there. So yeah, let me clamp it down, and then we can go from there. Let me see. Put this clamp on here. So
Sorry, folks, I only have two hands, so bear with me.
Okay, so that's just more or less where this thing needs to go. I just kind of put a clamp there. I haven't welded anything yet. And as you can see, it kind of wraps around. And kind of ends right here, where I'll be able to put a little weld on it. Actually, not here, because I want it to drain. This is going to be like a drain hole. So I don't want to close this up, but I will put a weld here, and then along the top, and then continue on all the way up to there. Now, when it comes to the actual support bracket itself, so this one's going to end right here, where I can still put a weld, and then on this top side right here, I'll be able to put a weld on it. So the actual bracket that's going to hold the sway bar D bracket is going to be just this piece of angle iron that I drilled some holes into. Two of the holes are for the actual bracket, which is going to sit like right in there and get welded to the other angle iron. Yep. So it's going to wind up like right in there with a couple bolts coming down. This is just a mock. Huh. Anyway, so yeah, it's gonna be right there. There we go. Right there, and then centered on the actual bracket, because that's where this bracket's gonna sit. That's the clearance that we need. And then this little nipple, I was able to find a 90 degree nipple that I'm gonna put in place of this vertical one, and I'll be able to grease that fitting, that joint, and hopefully it'll clear the torsion bar. But anyway, so there's that. And then to kind of give this more rigidity back here, because you can tell there's a gap, there's a space behind this angle iron, these holes are going to be weld holes, where I'm going to be able to weld into the frame in here, and then secure it there and secure it there into the frame and the angle iron behind it, just as a pivot, as a secure rivet point. And then this last piece will actually be welded also on the bench. You can tell it has a little curve on there, just to support that. And it's gonna be lined up with this one right there. And that's also gonna be just another little weld area to support that and make it all be nice and rigid and secure. And that's pretty much it, folks. I'm gonna weld all this up, and all the bolts line up. Now the sway bar is where it needs to be. I'll show you once it's all finished. I might end up putting a little gusset here. I'm not too sure yet, just to kind of support this angle iron here. I might still do it, just to give this angle iron more rigidity, because this torsion bar, I don't want this thing snapping or breaking or bending or anything with the weight of the truck and when you're off-roading. So gusset would reinforce it tremendously. Might be an overkill, I don't know, but it'll be just more supportive. So we'll show you once it's all said and done, folks. I hope this helps. If you like the videos, subscribe, and I'll keep doing stuff to it. All right. Later, folks. All right, folks. This is kind of what the finished product looks like. Kind of welded it up, grinded it, cleaned it up. It's not the best weld in the world. I'm not a certified welder, but it did its job. And it's on there nice and secure. And it should line up perfectly. So this thing, oh, it's actually kind of hot still. Oh, man. It's gonna go into this location where it's supposed to support the sway bar bracket. Bear with me here. This metal thing's still pretty hot. I'm on the grinding. So I'm just trying to push it in there. Okay, stand by. Let me put the phone down. Okay. That took a little while to get this thing in there, but it's in. Just had to wiggle it in there. So, that's pretty much it. That's the bracket. And I decided to go without the gussets just because I need to get in there and weld. And those gussets might get in the way, especially back here towards the front. So let me clamp it down, line it up, put the D-clamp here with the bushing and see what it looks like. All right, bye. Okay, so there it is. It hasn't been welded on yet, but I have it marked, you know, just with the bolts and a little bit of pressure pushing up on the sway bar with the floor jack right here, and everything lines up nice, perfect. So once I tighten these bolts, it'll bring the D-clamp up against this angle iron, and should be good, man. Problem solved. Got a weld all along the edge there, and that'll be it for this rust repair. All right, I'll show you once it's all finished. All right, talk to you later.